And I now give the floor to the distinguished representative of Zambia.
Distinguished co-chairs, excellences, distinguished delegates. Co-chairs, on behalf of Zambia, I would like to commend you and the Bureau for successfully organizing this second preparatory committee meeting for the Third World Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction to be held in Sendai, Japan in March 2015. I also commend you for the work done insofar as the zero draft is concerned, which is the basis for our negotiations during this meeting. In delivering our statement, Zambia aligns herself with the statement delivered by the Ambassador of Namibia on behalf of the African group and wishes to note the importance of these preparatory meetings as they provide a platform for all stakeholders to contribute towards the desired outcomes of the Third World Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction. Co-chairs, Zambia welcomes the zero draft, and in moving forward, we strongly feel that if we have to attain the goals and objectives of the Hugo Framework for Action 2, there is need for all of us, particularly developing countries, to overcome the following challenges. One, difficulties in fundraising of disaster risk reduction, interventions, and climate change adaptation, given the historical pattern of spending, which has been skewed towards response activities as opposed to disaster risk reduction. Two, reluctance of funding agencies to invest in disaster risk reduction given other competing needs. Currently, disaster risk reduction activities are viewed as cost lines and not investment lines. And three, failure to harmonize activities between the disaster risk reduction and climate change agencies, leading to duplication and overlaps in resource allocation and utilization. Co-chairs, in this regard, therefore, my delegation fully aligns itself to Africa's recommended areas of focus for the HFA2, namely regional risk factors and institutional frameworks, integration of disaster risk reduction and climate change adaptation, investments in disaster risk reduction and financing, technology transfer and capacity building mechanism to enhance implementation. Co-chairs, as the negotiations on the post-2015 framework of disaster risk reduction continue, we need to ensure that the proposed broad areas reflect the aspirations of our people so as to ultimately contribute towards building resilient communities and sustainable development. It is also Zambia's considered view that the post-2015 framework for disaster risk reduction should include measures to deal with health aspects such as make people's health and well-being as explicit outcome of the new global framework on disaster risk reduction, including health targets and indicators for the monitoring and reporting of disaster risk reduction, strengthening actions and resources to support health and other sectors that are vital for implementing disaster risk reduction, and to establish the Safe Hospitals Initiative as a global priority for action to ensure that new and existing health facilities remain operational in emergencies and disasters. Zambia therefore welcomes the deliberations of this meeting and will remain cooperative in her engagement. As to the elements of the political declaration as suggested by the government of Japan, Zambia is very much in support of the move and looks forward to strengthened country's commitment to disaster risk reduction at political levels as we move forward in dealing with natural hazards. Co-chairs, in conclusion, as we stated during the first preparatory meeting, we reiterate our call that the world should carry forward lessons learned in the implementation of the Hugo Framework for Action 2005 and 2015 so as to foster the gains from the process as well as inform the design of the successor framework. I thank you.
I thank the distinguished representative of Zambia.